Hi, I'm Lydia Jenkins. Welcome to this week's Husky Connections. I sat down with Dr. Haney and one of her students to explore her Geography Matters initiative. Dr. Haney uses different classroom methods to connect global issues to students' daily lives, tying it all to geography.
Geography Matters is one of the most important things that I emphasize in my introductory courses as well as my upper level geography and environmental science courses. The central question that I use to kind of start off all my courses is what is where, why there, and why care? And part of this has to do with the fact that I find that it's overwhelming for students when they first come into an introductory level geography course. And for so many of them, there's this sense of apathy about not only geography, but environmental issues. So I find that it's really easy for students to be dismissive if we're talking about an issue of global significance that they don't find any kind of personal link or personal connection to. So I try to aim to get them to understand how their lifestyles, how their daily choices and their daily decisions factor into some of those bigger life events and global significant events. So whether we're talking about issues related to climate change in sub-Saharan Africa or the accelerated aging of the population in Europe, it gets them to think about, well, what are the larger or the broader social, economic, political, ethnic effects of these things? And getting them to understand that for everything that's happening, there's a multitude of global, local, regional effects. So I think emphasizing that and the ability to get them to think critically and spatially about these things is really going to help them regardless of their career path that they choose after those classes.
Well, Dr. Haney spends an extreme amount of time taking care of her students, and even though you may have 100 students in a class, she will know all of them by name within the first month usually. Not only that, we've done journal articles, and they let you relate to different experiences that are happening throughout the world, give an evaluation and an opinion on those. And she likes getting feedback from the different backgrounds that all the students have. And also, instead of just putting a check mark at the top of the paper telling you that, oh, she's looked over it, she'll have an in-depth analysis of like what you've looked at and maybe try to get some feedback from your background. And even doing like little grammar things to help you improve your writing, even though she might not take off points for them. So that really helped me connect with the class, kept me interested in it. And like I said, getting that different background from not only myself, but other people in the class, let me look at things from different viewpoints as well.
One of the things that makes this unique to my specific course is that it allows students to get engaged with content that they're interested in. World Regional Geography is one of the broadest courses that we have in the department, and the goal is to get students to understand that these are just a multitude of issues that we could talk about in the most basic sense. And it's to get them interested in things like pop culture, sports, things that you wouldn't necessarily think have an apparent link to geography actually do. So it allows for them to also investigate topics that we may not get a chance to talk about in depth in World Regional Geography. So by allowing them to kind of look at what's happening outside the US and getting them to look at the news and actually looking forward to looking at what's happening in the news is something that I think will hopefully stick with some of them.
Her looking through, looking at my analysis, one day after class, we were just talking about my journals, and she's like, Nick, you do realize you're a geographer, right? And that was a big part in me changing my major, because getting that positive feedback from a professor and seeing that she is interested in the student and that she's taking a vested interest in us definitely helped my decision to change my major.
I think the big thing for me is that a lot of what shaped my experience with teaching is the department that I came from. And I'm actually an alum from the same department that I'm teaching in. And I've had the same professors that are now my colleagues and my mentors. So getting to be in a unique position like me, having had those professors that really stood out and they showed that they were passionate, they were excited about what they were teaching, they were flexible in their teaching. For example, if there was something that was going on currently that was of global political significance, they would be willing to say, okay, we're gonna scrap this and we're gonna talk about this because this is just as well relevant, and the students would be interested and they would be able to relate to those things. that was one of the things that really made the geography department stand out for me, and I constantly am able to look back and think about how those things have shaped how I got to where I am, and I'm convinced that if I wasn't in this department, I would have taken a very, very different path.
As a student with a geography minor and someone who has had Dr. Haney as a professor, I would personally say that her methods have helped me excel in all of my geography courses. This is just one of the many examples of how a professor can connect a major with a student's future. See you next time on Husky Connections.